Hello and welcome to Devil's Advocate. Should the government have a role in the way films are made and the sort of television programs we see? That's one of the key issues I shall explore today with the Minister of Information and Broadcasting, Ambika Soni. Mrs. Soni, let's start with your ministry's decision to send a notice to television programs like Sach Ka Samna and Pati Patni Aur Woh, or your decision to demand changes in a film that's to be made on the life of Edwina Mountbatten and Jawaharlal Nehru. Why in the 21st century, in a flourishing democracy, do you believe that the government is the best judge of what people should or shouldn't see?
No, I don't think government acts on its own. And I don't see government wanting to do that at all. But there is an ongoing debate, and I am lending all my strength to that debate, that let people decide. In the 21st century, in a democracy, let people decide what kind of infrastructure mechanism they want to have, which balances finally the rights of freedom of speech and expression, as well as the sensitivities of civil society.
Before I explore your thinking, are you saying to me that you believe this is a debate that has to happen and you have an open mind at the moment?
Absolutely open mind. I committed myself on the floor of the House in Parliament last session, and the broadcasters and wherever I am asked to address, I do say, please debate. But we have to, these two priorities have to be addressed simultaneously.
Let's then, in the light of your having an open mind, and I underline that, try and explore first of all your attitude to the film on Edwina and Nehru. Now both families, the Mountbatten family and the Nehru family, readily accept that they loved each other. Both families readily accept that this was a relationship that they were very happy with. Why then can't the film show them as two people who were in love?
We don't really get into the filmmaking aspect of Indian films, but films which are coming in from outside, they don't get permission from the Ministry of Home Affairs for their visas, etc., etc., till the content has been looked into by the IMB. This is not of my creation. This has been there for so many
that
years.
That I know, but the problem is that in the process of looking into the content, you're actually asking for changes. That's what I'm questioning.
No,
why?
It's not a question of changes, Karan. It's what I said right at the beginning. It's trying to balance. If we ask them to overlook some of the parts of the dialogue, the script, or to eliminate some of the script, it's a role which is performed also by the central board which gives film certifications, headed by Shalini Lattergo.
We'll come to the central board later. I want to talk about the ministry, the government of India. You represent the government of India. First of all, let me ask you simply but bluntly, do you accept, as Nayanthara Sehgal, Nehru's closest living relative, accepts, as Pamela Hicks, Lady Mountbatten's daughter, accepts, that the two loved each other?
Karan, I have no personal views. There are facts of history, there are other family members, there are lots of books written one way or the other. None of those books have been certified. I am not at all, at any stage, wanting to put my views on any subject onto the table.
But the problem is,
there are lots and lots of people who have different views. Maybe you haven't been in touch with them.
The only views that count are those of the relatives of the two. Pamela Hicks and Nayanthara Sehgal have both said publicly that they love each other. How can you dispute it?
I am not disputing anything. Neither am I questioning anything, Karan. I am not doing that. There is a mechanism in this ministry which doesn't involve the minister or our secretary or any of the officials. There are experts who have been retired ambassadors, retired IMB secretaries. They read the script, they have an idea of what civil society, Nehruji or AB, one of our leaders, are not just people who were only family has a right to say. India was their family.
Just a moment.
Yeah.
When it comes to their personal lives, only those who knew them intimately have a right to say whether it's right or wrong. If both people's closest living dependents say that in fact they were in love, how can any ambassador who didn't know them, how can any ministry who didn't know them dispute it, and therefore question the film showing they were in love?
No, Karan, nobody is disputing anything. The family knows people more intimately. Any family would know their family members more intimately than any outsider. It goes beyond doubt. But we are talking of something which is for public broadcast, for public showing. And we are a nation of billion people. So, and we do have our own right or wrong.
Is the truth to be hidden from a billion people?
It's not a question.
Are you
It's right or wrong.
Are you protecting Nehru and Edwina from the truth of their relationship?
No.
Because you're embarrassed by the fact
Look,
that you were
I am not going to get provoked by you, Karan. You may get as tough in your questioning as you want to, but I know the mechanism is there, which
okay.
doesn't only affect this particular film. In this one year, in the last three
can
years,
I interrupt?
97 films which have been made by outsiders, including your
Can I interrupt?
Can
I interrupt? Can I
has
put
been
to
done.
You? Can I put to you the consequence of what is intended and implied when you demand changes in the script to eliminate scenes where they are said to be kissing or scenes where they declare love to each other? After all, the family is happy if it's tasteful, you're not. So let me tell you the consequence. The consequence is that you're suggesting to people that there was something either improper or even morally unacceptable about this relationship. That's an insult to Nehru and Edwina. You're censoring their lives because you're embarrassed.
Karan? I saw your interview with Mrs. Nayantara Sehgal. I think she came across very well. Many of the things which probably I am not able to articulate as well as she did, she said the right thing. We are not talking of a film. I'm talking of a mechanism in place which has this film and 97 other
can
films. I'm sorry, that is all I can say
can I
on
put
this
you?
Subject.
Can I put
and I
you?
Don't want to
can I put
this
you? You say you saw the interview with Nayantara Sehgal done for
yeah.
Network 18
yeah.
and you admired what she said. Let
yes.
me quote to you what she said.
No, I
let me,
know.
No,
you
let me
don't
quote
have
you.
To
the
quote
audience
me.
Wants to be
Karan,
reminded. The audience wishes to be reminded. I don't think governments should lay down rules in the matter of art. I don't think art should be controlled. And then she adds, pointedly, every filmmaker is an individual. Each of them has their own style and approach. And you cannot lay down the law about how much is to be shown or done,
That's
how
right.
much of private life is to appear or not. It is a discretional judgment of the person making the film. Why are you not allowing the filmmakers to exercise their discretion?
No,
why are
I
you
am,
imposing yours on them?
I am not. I have been Minister of Culture. I not only endorsed what she said, I followed for 3.5 years as Minister of Culture not to put what government wants on any of our academies dealing with art and culture, music or dance or writing. Having said that, I have to talk to you about a mechanism in place which is mandatory to get permissions from the Home Ministry to look at. It should not disrupt feelings. It depends on how it's presented. And Karan,
can I
have really nothing
can
else
Can I make
to
a
say
point? What lies,
no, I'm not
behind, what lies behind the Ministry's position is the assumption that somehow the government of India knows what's right, what's decent, what's in good taste. What qualifies you or your ministry or your officials to determine that?
No, there's a mechanism. These are not individuals
it's
in the ministry.
It's an outdated mechanism. It shouldn't exist
All right,
in a democracy.
Then let's start a debate. If it's outdated, I welcome a debate. Let there be a debate in civil society, whether everybody in this country wants that anyone may come to India and do what they like, and then have it for public showing, how people would react, what would be... Did you recall Nayantara Sehgal saying, there are people whom we have not yet been able to deal with in a way
she
democracy
was talking
allows
about
us.
Hooligans
no,
and
know,
goons. She talked about Sena
Karan,
mobs rampaging. She talked about Sena mobs rampaging.
No,
you're
not
on their side, are you?
I am not talking of anybody. I'm repeating what Nayantara highlighted.
And I'm clarifying what she said, because she said it to me. One last thing. Do you know the impression you give that somehow you think the Indian people will be misled by a film?
No.
That they don't have the capacity to discriminate?
Not at all.
Isn't this an insult
not
to the Indian
all.
People?
Not at all. There is an independent mechanism in place which deals with every film which comes in the manner which we feel is as enlightened and as free from government controls as possible. If it is not suitable, let there be a public debate. I welcome it. We will bring
the problem is who judges suitability?
No, let there be a public debate. Aren't we talking
about... But there can't be a public debate.
Aren't we talking about the broadcaster?
But the debate can only happen when the film is made. You're not letting
no,
the film happen.
No, Karan. I'm sorry. You are talking about a film. I am not.
Okay.
I'm talking about the mechanism. I mentioned to you that in the last 4 years, 97 films sought clearance. Those are the rules, law of the
All
land.
Right.
I can't change it.
That's the law
so
of the
motto.
Land, but you said you welcome a debate.
I welcome
Let's
a
hope
debate.
That is the debate. Let's
I welcome.
Take
Start
a,
it, Karan.
Let's take a break at that point. Let's come back and switch to something that for many is perhaps more important. The government's expressed intention to regulate news TV. Is it justified or could it amount to the thin end of the wedge of censorship? That's in a moment's time. See you after the break. Welcome back to Devil's Advocate and an exclusive interview with the Minister of Information and Broadcasting, Ambika Soni. Mrs. Soni, let's come to television news. Why does the government believe there is a need for a regulatory authority? Why can't you accept, with specific reference to news, that self-regulation is best and anything else would undermine freedom of expression and press?
That's the debate about. I've committed myself on the floor of the House that we are talking to the self-regulatory bodies like the NBA, the Editors Association, which is a recent association, the IBF, the ASCII, which looks after the advertisers. There has been a debate in this country from 1997. Different parties, governments in office have brought in legislation which hasn't been able to fructify. I have opened it up.
The point I'm actually questioning is, why is there a debate when there is no need for a regulator for press, for newspapers, for magazines? Why is there a need for a regulator for TV news?
Because,
after all, on what basis are you discriminating,
Karan,
between the two?
You got it wrong.
There is no regulator for newspapers.
Believe it or not, Karan Thapar is wrong.
No, there is no regulator for newspapers.
We are not wanting to put in place a regulator to monitor content. That's not the intention of the government at all.
I'm very glad to hear that, because let me clarify for you.
The guidelines on your website
make it clear that you believe a regulatory authority is necessary. Are you now saying to me that this is not intended for TV news? The TV news will be excluded.
It is not only for content control. Most ministries which have public dealing have put in place...
Now you're sliding back to what you just now contradicted.
No, listen to me. Why don't you give me a chance, please? One, every ministry is putting in place a regulator, and I have assured the House, to which I am answerable to the Parliament, that it would be independent, autonomous, without government control, not only to address sensitivities of civil society or the concerns and the rights of the broadcasters, but also to look at other issues.
But we're back
whether,
to
you have enough free band, whether you have enough bandwidth, how many broadcasters.
You've now accepted in that answer that you are looking at a regulator for TV news. And I put it to you, let me finish, then you answer. If you don't need a regulator for newspapers and magazines, why do you need a regulator for TV news? Why are you discriminating between the two?
Please, it's not what we are talking of, is a mechanism. You may call it regulator, as most people you try is a regulator. The Petroleum Ministry has a regulator. The other
newspapers don't.
No,
magazines
no,
don't.
Listen,
why should TV news have a regulator?
This is not a regulator in the sense of content control. I can't go on repeating.
Then what do you mean by the word regulator?
Regulator,
because it's on your website.
That's what's under discussion. It's been on the website for 2 years, since 2007. It's being discussed. What needs to be taken off? What needs to be added, whether we want to dump it all together, put in place a new thing, the whole thing.
You said three important things that I want to clarify. First of all, you're saying this is not a regulator in the sense of regulating content.
That's right.
Is that confirmed?
I'm not looking at a regulator only to monitor content.
Oh,
no.
When you say only to monitor then it suggests it will monitor content as well as other things.
No.
Is content excluded?
Listen, come on, Karan, please don't push me. I cannot preempt a debate. I've told you there's a debate going on, and I haven't even put a time frame on the debate. Let there be a debate. And when I say this is going to happen, who am I?
So we could end up with a regulator.
I know. I'm not saying. I don't know. I don't know what everybody will decide, what they want. I said, to give a small example, that the NBA, the News Broadcasters Association, has a grievance redressal committee headed by Justice Verma. Now, I said, if there is a mechanism, you may call it what you
a
like, council.
For what? For what? What's the purpose
of
the mechanism?
For addressing concerns of the broadcasting sector.
Create a press council equivalent for TV. That's acceptable. Don't create
a
regulator.
But I'm just saying
so
that.
Would you change
now
the word?
Can
you stop using the word regulator? It would clarify a lot of doubt.
You are using the word
it's
regulator.
It's on your website. That's why I'm using it.
They are calling it a broadcasting regulatory
Council. Authority of India.
Council.
Broadcasting Regulatory Authority
Change
of
the
India.
Name.
The name. So remove the word regulator.
Karan, look, I'm not going to fight with you on words. I've been too long at answering interviews, especially by Karan Thapar.
But words convey meaning.
I have not taken over to myself. Give me a minute. I have not appropriated to myself, as Minister IND, any power to either name a body or to attribute its functions or to decide its the perimeters of its terms of reference. I have left it to the Secretary on our behalf, and the representatives of the broadcasting association.
But you're still minister, you carry the can.
No, why? I'll step down if it helps. At least I have started the debate.
Let me go back.
Do you know there is an alternative? No, Karan, please.
There is an alternative.
The alternative is what's happening today. Some people don't like a serial. They start sending the broadcasters or the channels concerned direct notices.
Mrs. Soni, I'm talking specifically about you.
I
can understand your need.
I don't want the ministry to play the role of an
regulator. I can understand your need to regulate entertainment channels because there it is a question of ethics, morality and other stuff. I'm talking specifically about news. I'm saying exclude television news from the ambit of a regulator. Create a press council equivalent, but not a regulator.
Let that be the outcome of this debate which has started.
Do you have an open mind?
I have an absolutely open mind.
Question to reconfirm. You also are accepting that people have perhaps been misled by the use of the word regulator. You don't intend regulation of news.
I have clarified that. I don't want to regulate anything from the ministry. I want whatever, by whatever name everybody decides, some other mechanism which is fair, credible, autonomous to do that job. The commitment of Dr. Manmohan Singh and the UPA government, that's the mandate I have.
Two quick questions. I want to quote to you what Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru said in 1950. I have no doubt that even if the government dislikes the liberties taken by the press and considers them dangerous, it is wrong to interfere with the freedom of the press. And then he adds pointedly, I would rather have a completely free press with all the dangers involved in the wrong use of that freedom than a suppressed or regulated press. Do you agree with that? Or are you trying to find a way of reversing what you said?
That's the legacy we've got. We are proud of that. And that's the mandate.
Are you committed to it?
That's the mandate I have been given the day I assumed charge by the Prime Minister.
Then one last question of clarification. It's so important that I'm repeating something just to get a clear answer. You have said to me that you will try and see, first of all, that the word regulator doesn't mislead people into thinking that there's content control of news.
I know what you are saying because you asked me 3-4 times in different
ways. Just for clarity.
No, there's no clarity I can give further than what I've said. You know what happened after 26/11. You know that. And you know how all of you felt bad by what, because of
now
the lack of...
Now you're sliding back.
I'm just trying to clarify my point. Instead of sounding repetitive, like you are almost, I want to tell you the News Broadcasters Association and the Editors Association have asked me as minister to help facilitate an empowered nodal group on behalf of the government, which they could access in times of an emergency.
Yes, but we're talking about different things now. We're talking about different things.
When that is there, they will know whom to access. They said
But no regulation.
No regulation.
On that point, let's end it. A pleasure talking to you, although perhaps you could have been a little clearer, but you've said enough to give people hope.
Thank you, Karan. I wish you to change your format. Oh, God.